Hello and welcome to my channel. This is Jerome Salangit Agas. I currently taking a Master's of Computers in Engineering, specialized in Data Science and Engineering at Polytechnic University of the Philippines. Intelligent System and Robotics is one of my subject in my current curriculum, and my activity is paper review in Robotic Processing Automation or RPA. And the title of my paper research review is Robotic Process Automation or RPA Implementation Drivers, Evidence of Selected Nordic Companies. First, we know the author. So letter A, who has have done the work? So first is Damian Kadziora from Hanken School of Economics. So his contact number is damian.kadziora@hanken.fi. Okay, the second author is Arja Leivonen from Jyväskylä University of Applied Science, and her contact information is arja.leivonen@student.jamk.fi. And the third author is Wojciech Piotrowicz from Hanken School of Economics, and his contact information is Wojciech Piotrowicz@hanken.fi. So, and the fourth and the last author is Anchi Orni from Abu Academy, and his contact information is anssi.orni@abo.fi. So, letter B, what were their goals or objectives? The purpose of the research was to explore new perspective on how the digital transformation with use of RPA affects enterprises' operations. According to Miriam N. Tisdell, 2015, the applied research is designed to improve the practice quality. Okay, next is the main purpose in the evaluation research is to form a basis for business decision making by collecting data on the value of a process, technique, or program. In this paper, the focus is to develop insights about the pattern considering the process of RPA solution and decision making. The goal of this exploratory research is to examine the key decision making factors related to the implementation of RPA at Nordic companies in the context of the organizational setup and culture. So, first is, what is RPA? So, Robotic Process Automation or RPA both have the same digital skill set as people and then some. Think of RPA bots as a digital workforce that can interact with any system or application. For example, bots are able to copy-paste, scrape web data, make calculation, open and move files, parse emails, log into program, connect to APIs, and extract unstructured data. And because bots can adapt to any interface or workflow, there's no need to change business system, application, or existing processes in order to automate. Okay, so robotic process automation has a positive snowball effect on business operation and outcomes. RPA delivers measurable business benefits right out of the gate, think cost reduction, greater accuracy, delivery speed, then continues to add values as it picks up a momentum and spread across the organization. RPA improves business outcomes like customer satisfaction and enables competitive advantages by freeing human to do what they do best, solving problems, improving processes, conducting analysis, and other value-added work, resulting in higher employee engagement and new revenue opportunities. So that's the RPA. Okay, letter C, what were the research question, if any? Okay, number one, what was the role of IT department in the RPA development? So second, what decision criteria are used for RPA development? Number three, what are the risks related to RPA implementation? So number four, and the last, how independently to do software robots in process automation work? Okay, so the first question is asking what is the role of the IT department? The second is the criteria of the RPA development. And the third is the implementation. What are the risks? Okay, number four is about the independency of the software robots in process automation work. Letter D, what were their methods in terms of but not limited to? Number one, how have they gathered relevant data? Who are the participants? The participants is the experts involved in the development of intelligent automation solution at selected Nordic enterprises. So they ask the company that is connected to Nordic enterprises. Okay, so next is how is the data gathering set up? Through interview. So that's all. They have a 4 question they ask to the interviewee. So the data gathering setup is through interview. So third, what are the tools and techniques used in the data gathering? The tools or techniques is the questioning technique. So through interview, that's questioning technique. Okay, so number two, how do they form the data set? How do they clean the data? Not applicable because the research is defined as a research used to investigate a problem which is not clearly defined. So by the way, investigative research is a name given to a collection of research techniques and methods used by researchers, including journalists, social scientists, and others. It is intended to unearth secret, hidden, or obscure information that can be built a more comprehensive picture of the issue under investigation. Okay, so that's all about the investigative research. So let's proceed to the letter D. So number three, how do they process the data and or how do they develop the fuzzy logic? In my opinion, they have a lot of variation of their answers. Since the people or enterprises is on the interview, so I think the fuzzy logic there is the weight of the answers or the scores of their answers. I didn't see the research paper that they use a fuzzy logic, but I think the participants there are using the fuzzy logic or the process data of the fuzzy logic because they implemented the RPA. So I think the participants is the one who uses a fuzzy logic there. So letter E, what were their findings? First, the findings highlight the focus on the operational benefits like releasing employee from the most monotonous or non-value-adding assignment, strengthening enterprise efficiency, compliance, and quality. So second, the findings suggest that RPA is mainly perceived as an operational tool to automate and improve internal processes with little consideration of its strategic and external impact, including impact on customer and service quality. So next, letter F, what were their gaps in their studies or findings? As RPA become a disruptive technology, its strong impact on the global services market got identified in the decision factor of following market trend, a competitive pressure from other organizations that widely implemented RPA. So next is the study offers practitioners aggregate insights onto the importance and role of benefits and risk driving RPA deployments that shall help them in the complex decision-making process. For the future research, I recommend exploring how RPA is changing the market position of the company, influencing customer services, process quality, as well as the ability to change processes at request. How flexible can RPA be in management? So that's all. Maybe you learned something new about robotic process information. Before I end my presentation, I would like to thank all of you for listening in my RPA paper research review. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye. With the numbers.